People are intimidated by their sense of perfectionism. Churchill's totally right when he says, perfection can also be spelled paralysis. It's when we obsess over getting it exactly right that we don't get down to do the dirty work of it. People have been procrastinating for thousands of years. That's just part of the human condition. 20 centuries ago, Seneca says the one thing that all fools have in common is that they're always delaying to live. They're always putting it off. They're delaying getting started because they'll get to it later. It's not that important. Someone else will take care of it. This is no way to do it, right? Procrastination is a very real thing. We've always struggled with it. We continue to struggle with it, but that's not who you want to be. You have things you want to do. You know you have a limited amount of time. You know there are things you've been put on this planet to do. How do we beat procrastination? I think you start with the Stoic idea of tackling it action by action. Marcus Aurelius says, don't get crushed by the whole of life. Don't let your imagination get carried away. Stick with the situation at hand. Say, why is this so unbearable? Why can't I endure it? He said, you'll be embarrassed. So I think oftentimes we get intimidated by stuff because we make it bigger than it needs to be. We think, well, what about this and this and this and this? And then of course we don't do it. We put it off because we're scared by it. We've made ourselves scared. And so I think if you can zoom in your focus, you'll have a lot more luck, right? So Nick Saban talks about the process. He says the average down in football is like 7 seconds. Just do your job, 7 seconds. Don't let the timeline get carried away, right? And I think if we zoom way in on the task, we're gonna have a lot more success. This ties into another Stoic idea, just do a little thing. Zeno says that well-being is realized by small steps, but it's no small thing. Marcus Aurelius says, you know, assemble your life action by action. If we can just do one little thing every day, remember Seneca saying that the path to wisdom is just acquiring one quote, one insight, making one bit of progress every day. If you can think that way, then the task is not so overwhelming. When I tackle a book, I don't go, oh, I have to write this huge book. It's going to be 80,000 words. I'm going to have to go through multiple rounds of edits. I break it down into many, many different small composite pieces. The obstacle is the way is 32, 33 chapters, but I broke that down into three parts. And then 10 chapters in each part. And then, you know, the beginning of the chapter and the end of each chapter. And I just try to tackle each one each day. There's a great rule in writing, just 2 crappy pages a day. You do 2 crappy pages a day. If I show up and write every day, published pages come out of the backside of it. That's like a reality of the business. And realizing that, hey, crappy pages come out of the backside if I show up, tackle a little bit each day. That's a really important thing. But I think this is another part. People are intimidated by their sense of perfectionism. Churchill's totally right when he says, perfection can also be spelled paralysis. It's when we obsess over getting it exactly right that we don't get down to do the dirty work of it, right? So I don't focus on the results. As they say in the Bhagavad Gita, you're entitled to the work, not the fruits of the work. So my job is to just get to work every single day. I'm very routine focused. I think you have to be routine. I think a lot of the reason people procrastinate is because they're overwhelmed, right? They have a chaotic life. They have a million things that they're doing. And because they have a million things that they're doing, they don't focus. So Marcus Aurelius says, every day, every minute, we have to ask ourselves, is this essential? We eliminate the essential things from our life, from our routines, from our to-do list. Again, I have a short, tight to-do list every day. I'm writing chapter 6, part 2 of the next book, right? That's a big part of it for me. I'm not thinking, oh, I've got all these million things to do. No, I have my little piece in front of me today and I'm gonna tackle that thing. And by knowing what I have to do today and what I don't have to do, as Marcus says, we get the double benefit of doing less better. I'm a big believer too of tackling the big, hard parts first, right? So I wake up, I tackle the hard thing for the day first. I think it's also when you're pushing things off till later, I'll do that in a couple weeks, I'll do it when things slow down, I'll do it in the afternoon when I feel more like it. That's a recipe for never actually getting around to do it. Epictetus talks about how every situation has 2 handles. Grab the heavy handle, get the hard thing out of the way. Don't even create room for procrastination to creep in. So this is a really key part of it, I think, is creating a schedule, a routine, a set of habits or systems that don't allow that procrastination to leap in. Seneca says, life without design is erratic. As soon as a system is in place, principles become necessary. And look, if you're all over the place, you're not gonna default to doing your best work. The small wins, really important. As I was saying, a couple crappy pages a day. I know that if I do that day in and day out, I will get a manuscript which I can then refine. If I am obsessed with the results, with what other people think, I'm not gonna be in the best headspace. By obsessing about what other people think by the results, that also contributes to being intimidated or overwhelmed because I'm nervous, right? I'm thinking, well, what are they gonna say? What if I don't get it right? What if I don't do it right? And that's not a place you wanna come from. So again, by zooming in and saying, what's in front of me? What do I control? What can I do well? What can I do to the best of my ability? Even if that's just a couple crappy pages a day, I've narrowed in what I'm supposed to be intimidated by. I think Stephen Pressfield's right. You know, he says, you experience the most resistance on the most important things. I don't procrastinate brushing my teeth. I do procrastinate, you know, starting the next book because it's gonna push me, it's gonna be scary, it's gonna challenge me. So in a sense, procrastination, the more resistance you feel, it's probably a sign you're onto something. It may be a sign that this is the most important thing that you could ever do in your life. And so as we're delaying, as Seneca says, as we're putting stuff off, we should almost go towards that. That hesitation we're feeling, that's confirmation that this is a good thing for us to do. There's a great video that Arnold Schwarzenegger did. Someone was asking, how is he still in shape? And he says, just that you do one thing every day, that's what counts. So I know if I'm just putting points on the board, putting my ass in the seat, doing some writing, that's gonna cumulatively add up to where I wanna get. That's gonna cumulatively add up to the pages which can be edited and eventually published. I think we can often be so paralyzed by what other people think, by our own standards, that we don't do the work, and because we're not doing the work, then we don't feel good about ourselves and we lose confidence. It's a momentum thing. I try to keep myself as a writer always at my fighting weight. What I mean by that is I always wanna be writing a book. Starting a book is really hard, especially if you've not been writing a book. So to always be in the middle of a book, that prevents procrastination, laziness, complacency from creeping in. My last book, Lives of the Stoics, when it came out, I was just in the middle of winding down the next book. And then I'm in the middle of the next one now. So I'm always writing, and my routine is a big part of, you know, it's sort of a defense mechanism from that complacency or procrastination creeping in. In Zen and the Art of Archery, you hear Eugen Herigel talk, very similar actually to something that we get from Cicero, the image of the archer. And he talks about you aim it, you let it go, but then it leaves your hands. And so the understanding that at a certain point, this project leaves your control, and that you can't care about that as much, I think also reduces the stakes a little bit and helps you see this calmly and clearly and be a little less intimidating. Everywhere is nowhere is a great saying. So if your life is chaos, disordered, you're trying to do a million things at the same time, that's a way of procrastinating. Busyness, being overwhelmed, not having the bandwidth to do a thing is just as bad as sitting on the couch and saying, oh, I'll get to it later. So you have to really ask yourself, what matters? What am I really trying to do? What are my main priorities? And then focus ruthlessly on those things. Procrastination is real. We all suffer from it. We all deal with it. Marcus Aurelius, Seneca, me, you. Procrastination, as I said, is part of the human condition, but we beat it with systems, with routine, by focusing on what's essential, by making a little bit of gain every day, putting one foot in front of the other. There really is no other way. But the final part of memento mori, you could die, who knows how much time you have left. Why would you waste it? Why would you put off till tomorrow when tomorrow is uncertain, to me, is the ultimate way of battling procrastination and concentrating like a Roman, as Marcus Aurelius said, doing this as if it is the last thing you were doing in your life. Let's do it like that, and I think we'll be amazed at what we're able to accomplish. For the Stoics, wisdom was an ongoing process. It was a journey. Zeno said that well-being is realized by small steps, but it's no small thing. So how do we do that? Well, I suggest the Daily Stoic email. You can sign up at dailystoic.com/email. One email every single day, totally free. The best wisdom and insights from the Stoics, from Zeno to Marcus Aurelius, Epictetus, and Seneca. Sign up, start your journey. Let me know what you think.